Okay, Matt, Tiffany, we have your transmission disassembled. I wanted to show you this part first. He's actually got a lot of this washed up and cleaned up, ready for assembly, so we can get this done for you today. This right here is your fourth clutch hub. And what I'm going to do is have Carl, my master builder, walk you through this. And I'll show you, have him explain that hub, and then I'll take you over and show you the parts that we found.
Right here is splines. And on yours, it's stripped, completely gone. And that's why you didn't have fourth gear.
Okay, let's walk over here.
This is what yours looks like. It's just smooth right here. There's no splines left. Here's a pump shaft. That's what drives your pump. I don't know if you can see right here. The splines are razor thin, and them are about to strip out. Here's a band for manual low. You can see right here it's supposed to be brown in color, but the rest is black from slipping. And that's going to have to be replaced. Here's the steels for fourth gear. They're supposed to be shiny, but right here you can see the purple hot spots. They've been slipping. They're going to have to be replaced. Here's the sun gear. I don't know if you can see right here. The gear itself is pitting and falling apart, and that's going to have to be replaced.
Okay, and this is the rest of the transmission. The metal that's gone through here has gone into the torque converter, which is right here. That will also have to be replaced, as well as a couple of electronics. The major one is the EPC, which is the electronic pressure control solenoid that controls the hydraulic pressure inside the transmission. The rest of this is getting ready to be stuck in the wash to get it all cleaned up, free of any debris and dirt. The cooler system on this will have to be flushed thoroughly. I'll show you that here in just a minute. I'll have the estimate written up and attached to this email as a PDF. Review the information and then give myself or Larry a call and let us know what you want to do. We should be able to have this done for you by the end of the day. Thanks, Matt and Tiffany.
Okay, this is our hot flush machine, and it's not hooked up to your car, but it's going to be. And this is just an example to show you how it works. As you can see on the side here, the hot flush is hooked up to shop air pressure. That runs over there to the lift. And then these hoses are hooked to the vehicle. And what happens is this runs heated transmission fluid through the transmission cooler system in the vehicle. And what it does, this heated fluid gets up to about 190 degrees. Right now, it's only at about 179 degrees. But it'll get up to 190, and we usually set the timer for 3 hours. This one is currently set for 1 hour. We'll bump this up. But 3 hours is a normal time that we run it. And it runs heated fluid for 3 seconds, and then for half a second, it blasts 150 pounds of shop air the opposite way. And that's the pulsation that you see and hear. And right now, this one, it'll get up to about 60 pounds. Right now, it's running about 20 pounds, but it'll get up here to 50 or 60 pounds. And then it also measures volume here. Right now, this is flowing about 5 gallons a minute. What that's flowing. I don't know if you see that with the glare on it or not. Let's see if I get a better shot of that. Where that orange line is, that's right at 5 gallons a minute. And it's heated fluid, and it gets all that metal and clutch debris out. And this is a state-of-the-art machine. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. That's the hot flush machine, and that's what's going to be hooked up to your car to get all that contamination out of the cooler.